current challenge for industry, society and governments is how to deal with climate change.
Many countries and industry groups have committed to net zero, and this requires that we remove billions of tons of CO2 from the atmosphere. Direct air capture is a space that's getting a lot of attention at the moment. The challenge is the cost and the efficiency of these systems still needs improving, despite the great progress that these groups have made.
The CarbonAssist project basically was established as part of our strategy into decarbonisation and transitioning fuels. The drivers of the project have been to achieve a technology by which it can capture CO2 directly from the atmosphere at a very low cost. It's also adaptable, versatile, and its modular design allows it to be applied to different industries.
In order to capture CO2 from the atmosphere requires new materials that are designed to work at those particular concentrations.
The CarbonAssist direct air capture unit works by employing a carbon capture polymer that was developed by CSIRO. And the way it works is a series of trays are loaded with the carbon capture material. Air flows over the trays until they're saturated with CO2.
What's unique about the chemical is we've took two of the main classes of carbon capture solvent, which are porous solids and liquid systems, and we've combined them in such a way to generate a material that's highly selective for CO2 from the atmosphere. The way to think of it, it's like a sponge that's being soaked in a liquid, and that liquid is retained within the sponge.
Once the trays are fully saturated with CO2, we isolate the trays from the atmosphere by closing a series of valves, and then we apply heat to the trays themselves to desorb CO2, and then we repeat that cycle of absorption and desorption.
The CarbonAssist technology is being designed to be very scalable. In the past 12 months alone, we've gone from lab scale to multi-ton scale, and we're currently building a pilot plant that will be deployed into Australian industry, and that's designed to capture 90 tons of CO2 per year. We're also building a larger system that's designed to capture 365 tons per year.
When we started developing CarbonAssist, it was clear that we needed to build collaborations with suppliers, manufacturers and service providers to deliver a supply chain which met the needs of the current pilot project as well as those of future commercial operations.
The next steps of the technology is upscaling and its implementation, not just here in Australia, but across different countries and regions, basically having a global impact.